Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Middleware Technologies. Today we will be looking at Godman new feature that is like archiving the container images. Okay, so there are two commands or utilities you can say which are provided by Godman, which we can use to archive our container image, and again we can basically load that image from that archive. Okay, so what is the main purpose of using those options, saving it into an archive and loading the image from an archive? Okay. So basically, whenever we are trying to utilize our image, we download it from the container registry. Okay, so it will take some time for the first download, because it will download the base image and the other layers that are used for that image. So it will take some time for the user to download the complete image. But once the image is downloaded, we can save that image into an archive, and we can share that archive with the other user, so that the other user won't be required to download again it from the container registry. Rather, they can directly utilize the image, or whatever has been modified with the image, they can directly utilize that image and try to run the container out of it. Okay, so let's try to understand more on the options that the commands that are available. So I have my Godman installed. Okay, so let's try to understand the two commands that we will be using. So let me try to do Godman help. Okay, so here if you see, I'll just scroll down a bit up. So you can see this one, save command. So basically it saves an image into an archive. Okay, so this is how we'll be able to convert an image into an archive, archival format. Okay, so once that is converted into an archive, we can share that archive with other users or anybody who wants to use that image, and they can actually load that image from the archive. So this is the next command or option we have, that is load, that loads the image from a tar archive. Okay, so let's try to get more details from the commands. So I'll do Godman save help. Okay, so this basically prepares our archive. So we need to pass the image that we want to archive for this one. So let's try to do this activity. So let me first initially download one image. Right now I do not have any images on my machine. Okay, so let me try to pull docker.io. So I'm just pulling HTTPD image from Docker. Okay, so you can see I have just now pulled my Docker image, that is HTTPD image from Docker registry. Here you can see there are a lot of binary objects that have been downloaded or copied. Okay, so basically these all are called layers of that image. Okay, so whenever like an image is prepared, it is built on top of a root file system, and on top of that we place our own like commands which will create additional layers. So this is how the image is built. So with this like you will get to know how many images image layers are available with this like SJWPD package. Okay, so yeah, so right now like we have our image available. Okay, and one more thing I wanted to show is so I'm right now with a non-root user. Okay, and for this the podman images are stored in the home directories like hidden folder. Okay, so let me try to clear my screen and show you. So I'm right now in my home directory. So so there is a local folder, let me go into this one, clear my screen. So if you go into share, there will be containers folder, storage. So this is where actually the layers are getting downloaded, like I have overlay layers. Okay, you can see all this zip tar zip packages. These are actually all the layers that got downloaded when we like try to pull the HTTPD image. Okay, so this is one thing that you can take a note of. So basically and one more thing. Okay, so right now I am in a non-root user, so if you go into, so that's why like the container images are downloaded into the home directories like local share container storage folder. Okay, so this is where it stores. So this information also you can get it from podman info. So you can see this graph root basically this points to the home directory. So this is where and the config file, all these things are available in the home directory within the dimension folders. Okay, so this is how we can identify the layers which have been downloaded onto our system when we put the image. Okay, so let's get back to the image that we have downloaded. So we have our image, and yeah, let's now try to convert this image into a the archival format. Okay, so let me do go into my home directory and create one folder. Archive. So I'll do my activity over here. Okay. Okay. So let me fetch my image ID. Okay. So we'll do podman save. The image ID into new HTTPD dot tar. So basically we are converting our image into a tar file. Okay, you can see basically all the layers that have been downloaded initially, that is blobs and the config and the manifest, all those things have been written back into this archive. Okay, so let's try to extract or try to check what is there in the archive, tar-tvf. Okay, so as you can see, these are all like tar files that were unzipped, like the manifest file, and all these layers have been like extracted and like have been tarred into this folder, okay, with along with the manifest. So this is how like basically it will store the complete layers of image into a archive, like in the tar format. Okay, now we have our like image stored in that tar format. So let me try to delete my image that I pulled. Okay, so I'll do podman rmi to delete my image that I have pulled. Okay, so there is no need of this image right now, because like I have already like archived that image. Okay, so now you can see there is no image. Okay, now let's try to load that archive into and convert it into an image. Okay, so for that we need to use podman load, and for that we will pass the standard input, that is new httpd dot tar file. Okay, so this basically tells the podman to load the image from this archive which we have created, and let us name this new like image as new httpd, or let's name it as loaded httpd. Okay, so let's do. Okay, so it has extracted that profile, and it has loaded the file systems or image layers from that tar file into our local system and stored it into the storage folder. Okay, so we can check it. So let me do podman images again. Okay, so you can see the new repository, like it shows the local repository loaded httpd, which has created our image dd8 plus cd bb99. okay, so that means like we have loaded our image from the archive. Okay, so we can try to run this like httpd image which we have loaded from the archive. So let me try to run it. Podman run in detached mode, and let's do port forwarding with 888 from host. It should port forward to 8080, which is available in the okay, 8080. Let me check the image also once. Podman inspect. I just wanted to check what is the port that is available. So the exposed port is 80. So I need to forward my request onto this one. So let me do podman images again. And let me run this image in detached mode. Minus P. Let me do 80888. Forward it to 80 on the container. Okay. And let me pass the image name. Okay, done. So we have started our image, like container image, from the image that we loaded. And let me check the process. So it is up and running and serving all requests. Our request on 8848 ports. Okay. Let me curl onto that port to check the default page that we get from the HTTP instance. Okay, I need to give the port as 888 because that is where we are doing the port forwarding. Okay. So it shows the HTML content, that is, it works. So you can test it from the browser also. So I have already loaded it, so it shows me the default page of the HTTP. Okay. So this is how you can do the basically archival of the images, and we can share that archive with anybody who wants to use it, and they can load it simply using that archive. Okay. So that is the main purpose of basically utilizing the save and load. Okay. So there is one more thing which Podman provides. Let me show it in the help. There's one more thing called export and import. Okay, so export basically exports the container file system content, and import basically imports and creates an image out of that the container archive that we created with export. Okay, but there is a major difference between using save and load and export and import. Okay. So save and load it captures the complete file system layers and archives that into a tar file, and it loads that as it is. And but in case of export and import, it actually archives the runtime instance snapshot, like what is the file structure, and it archives it into a tar format. Okay. And there's one more thing that I wanted to tell you about export import, but we'll try to look at that one in our next video. Okay. So until then, yeah, you guys have a good day, and I hope you learn something from this video. Thank you all, and thanks for watching this video. Happy New Year in advance for all of you, and it is only some hours left for the New Year to reach in some countries. Basically it will reach New Zealand first. So yeah, so Happy New Year to everybody in advance. Yeah. Thank you all, have a great day.